Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm John, this is Many a True Nerd, and welcome back to Total War Warhammer, the game of playing Total War, but in the Warhammer universe, which is broadly what you'd probably expect from the name. Last time we engaged with a pretty major scrap in the forest over here to fire a little warning shot at Middenland, because those bastards are apparently plotting against us. And today it is time for war against the smallest and weakest one of the territories in the Empire, and also the most unfriendly. You'd think they'd be a bit more diplomatic given how flimsy they are, but the Marienburg lot. We need to go and take them out. But they have a very big citadel, together with a big garrison and a big army set in there. Because in Total War Warhammer, and I quite like this, the defenders don't just have the advantage of the walls, they've also got the advantage that they're allowed to have a 20-stack army present, and the garrison doesn't count towards that stack limit. So therefore, really, you can have whatever the garrison is and 20 on top of that. And in a city capital, that means often you've got a 30-stack army at your command. That could be a little bit problematic, though I guess like if I did it, probably the 10 of the garrison would be computer controlled. Normally that's what happens in Total War. But how to take this? Well, I've been thinking about that, and one option could be, rather than going straight to the capital, we need to go for their other settlement, because they've got another one round here. I suspect it's over in this region somewhere. We need to go and take that, see if we can draw the army out, and thus, you know, start denying them their towns, fight them in the open field without the garrison, and then afterwards go and take on the garrison. So what we're going to do here is we're going to step in and we're just going to hide in the forest. They're going to be annoyed, mind, but hopefully it'll all be fine. Go over here, just step into the forests and just hope they're all okay with me. That's my plan. My plan is just to hide in the forest and hope they're okay with me. I think I could have come by sea if you like kind of go up to the port. Like these days, like I don't think there's like a navy that you move around, or if there is, like I don't have one yet. But had I just kind of stepped into the boats here, I could have just gone along the river, which arguably would have been a little bit better, to be honest, but no matter. And then I could have just kind of gone up this river, hopefully bypassing these rocks. It looks like it's like a ship shouldn't be able to come through this area, but I think it can. And then I could have just kind of gone past. But that's what I want to do. I just want to go straight past and ha-ha. This up here looks like it might be a village. Yes, here we are. This is exactly what I want to be taking on. This little village here. We're going to go over here and we're going to take that. And that is going to be Gorsal, apparently. And that's going to have... Ooh, it's got a little bit of a garrison, but nothing major. But let's see if that works. All right, what are the Marienburg lot going to do? Anything? No, they've decided against it. And I forgot to mention this before. Yes, indeed. You can't just take over everything and make it yours. So humans are only allowed to take over certain other settlements. So if I go to war with the dwarves, I can knock them out and I can raise their settlements and I can plunder them or whatever, but I can't actually go on to inhabit them myself. And Todbringer's Wrath event has just kicked off as well. Boris may one day become a great ally, one day. For now, he resents the duly elected emperor's ascension to the throne. Never a patient man or one to hide his fury, he will be difficult to appease. Diplomatic relationships minus 20 with Middenland. Okay. Looks like... Oh, and... Oh, not Schwarzhafen. I love Schwarzhafen. They made the best sausages. And the Skull Takers have also been obliterated. I'm guessing that was the faction that was wandering around here causing trouble with Middenland. The Middenlandians finally bloody got round to taking them out. Lovely. Now, importantly, Jondorf just leveled up to level 3. Perfect. And that means all sorts of very good things. One, of course, I can immediately, or rather, well, I can't because I don't have the money, but I could soon, if I wanted to, get myself an Empire Captain. And that is a type of hero. Marvelous. So that's a different type of hero than the battle wizard we've already seen. Alternatively, we've got the handgunners, armor-piercing missiles, the next step up from the crossbowmen. Very, very welcome. And great swords. Obviously, we know how good those are. I could upgrade my harbor, which would get me a bit of extra income. And more importantly, potentially, would unlock some new technologies. Very, very welcome indeed. So that would presumably get me even more income, potentially, from things like fishing fleets, yeah, merchant fleets and sea charts. Arguably the most important of all, there is a new slot I can fulfill. So obviously we've got everything we've already seen here. Weaving houses, a clay pit. Clay pit for more money. Why would I want that? Oh, okay. So the clay pit produces a lot less money in terms of like income straight away, but it produces a resource that presumably has a really positive impact on trade. You can't just trade. You actually need to have something to trade. So that's nice. A Shrine of Sigmar would get us a warrior priest as well. This is more of a kind of a battle-focused one here. So he can be embedded. He can heal your troops, prey, presumably morale bonuses, demoralize the enemy, assassinate, inhibit, don't know what that one is, damage, building, cleanse, corruption. Okay, so there's certain kind of similarities between the various kind of guys that you can have. But yeah, that's a very interesting one. Alternatively, a blacksmith for the recruitment of, the halberds and the empire knights, some shock cavalry. That one, I'm gonna find it hard to turn down. I wouldn't mind actually having some shock cavalry. But if I do want to recruit handgunners, I'm also going to need a gunsmith in the province. Well, that's fine. I can have a gunsmith over here in Aleheart when the time comes. And I understand, even though I've got a blacksmith, I won't be able to have Empire Knights straight away because you need the base building to produce Empire Knights, i.e. the second level of stables, which is going to be a while until Grunberg is ready to produce. So you really need to make choices about what you want to be able to make or not. There's also at the fourth level, three different types of wizard for different varieties of spells. That's very cool. So right now I've got a bright wizard, but there's also celestial and light wizards available. Nice. Well, the thing is, for now, this is all academic. I physically cannot afford any of this anyway. Though it looks like I can get some. Aha! The state troop sergeant. So now infantry recruited have a plus two experience. Very, very nice. That's actually been completed. Good, good, good. But yes, I can't afford any of this, though I will be able to soon by going to war. So you're back in normal march mode. Just go straight past the Marion guys, right? Grossel is way bloody over there. Right, I'm seeing the problem here. Because unfortunately, Grossel is, over on that coast. Which I didn't realise was going to be a thing. Well, in that case, go into march mode. It's time to go to the sea. There we are, we've now got ourselves a boat. And we need to take it over there, because apparently Grossel is, way over there. Which is unfortunate, but we definitely need to head over that way. Right, sorry, Marienburg. We need to go and take out one of your other towns first. What was it? Your other town is, relatively large, actually. Is that level 3? Blimey, you've got two decently strong towns here. And as the game was trying to tell me there, it's actually, I don't have to have just one of these. I can have as many of these as I want. I can just only research them one by one. So actually, even though I've already now got the plus 2 experience for new infantry units, I can also have plus 5 morale for them too. Marvellous, and that's just going to be 8 away. But you can only have one or the other. Got it. Now, while our electors' armies march forth, our nobles barter with each other, claiming great swathes of land for themselves. Should the common man, the brave soldier, not have a farmstead on which to retire? Yes, that seems reasonable. So take it back. They've got more than enough. A new approach. And that means we get public order minus 2, but leadership plus 4. Or they rule the politics of the Altdorf court are deep and complex. You'll need the favour of both the Graf and, those damn Graf. We need to get their favour. Better to keep them on side. That gets us a big pile of money and, I think we'll just have to accept a small loss. Oh, but I wouldn't mind the money. I would not mind the money at all. It's only 3 turns. Right, turns remaining 3. Yep, fine, I'm taking the money. There we go, and that gets us a nice giant pile of money. Now with that giant pile of money, we can start doing some impressive things. And when I say some impressive things, actually we're going to spend it very, very quickly indeed. If we want knights entering the army, that means we need to get Grunberg growing. If Grunberg grows, we can upgrade the stables, then we can upgrade a blacksmith over at Jondorf. Everything will be fine. Let's get that going. That's a good use of money. Money's starting to come in a bit faster. I've kind of got rid of a couple of the troops around Jondorf that weren't really necessary. Yes. Now, these guys here, we've decided to go over here. Now we can, are we allowed to just, undisembark over there. Perfect. And then, aha, I think we're actually ready to attack these guys immediately. Oh no, sorry, I can't just now because I'm actually in the march mode, which is the only way I was able to get this far. That's fine, go and hide in the forests for a bit. That's all okay. And the ships, the ships just kind of drop out of existence, unfortunately. Which may mean I'm a little bit... How do I get back out here, by the way? Like, the game says I can get on the water just by going up to the water here. Does that mean there just needs to be, like... Could I not go here because there were cliffs? As long as there's, like, a beach, I am allowed to go up there. I think that's how it works. Fine, you're stuck there for a moment. Meanwhile, the Sterlins have been attacked by the vampire counts. Oh dear. Well, that's not good. Sterlins has been attacked by the vampire counts, and apparently, the Sterlins apparently has the advantage by the vampire counts. All right, fine. Yep, I'm entering the war on the side of the ally. We're totally happy to be at war against the bloody vampire counts. And I'm guessing they're going to struggle to break Essen. That looks like that's relatively well defended over there. Mission successful. Altdorf has been pacified. That got up to plus 10. That gets me a big injection of the sort of money I need. Perfecto. And that lets me get the barracks going at my main capital. Good. We've got some money flowing in right now. This is starting to work. And you, however, over there, my friend, you need to come out of march stance into normal stance. And then these guys over here at Gorsal, they need to go down. And going to war against Middenland, I believe, will also get us a big injection of cash. I know you're completely green, by the way, and most of your armies never really had a fight before, but I'm sure we can do this. It's all absolutely fine. In we go. Declare war. So I've declared war against Marienburg. Now I can call Stirland to help. I don't think I need their help, to be honest. They're neutral, they're reliable. No, I don't need their help. I really don't need their help, it's fine. So I'd get like a minor advantage with their help, but I don't think I actually need to bother having the Empire declaring war on itself. I think we're absolutely fine, to be honest. No allies have chosen to become involved in the dispute. That's fine. That's okay. We're straight involved and we can just go straight in. Now the question is, do we even need to bother getting involved in this one? Honestly, I don't think we do. I think we can just move in and auto-resolve this one for a quick easy win, because it's literally just the garrison forces. What did we lose? Not much, to be honest. We'll get some experience, which is good, because that means we can actually upgrade our guy and our battle wizard before their first real battle. So, big experience for our leader, and presumably for our battle wizard as well. And we've got, yeah, we lost 41 guys, that's fine. Enemy captured 92. What are we going to do with those guys and what are we going to do with this area? Well, we're going to occupy it, I'd say. Ooh, 5,000. 5,000, intriguing. That's a big part. No, no, don't do it. All right, unit replenishment is better. Let's get our forces right back up to full strength and we'll move straight on. Occupy the settlement, please. And that now belongs to us. That's a big settlement we've just taken over. That's a beautiful big old settlement. And that also gives us a land boundary with flipping... Oh, that's Nordland. You're Nordland? Looks like you're Middenland. Are you the same colour? Wait, where's Middenland? There's Middenland on the map. And then go over here. And this is Nordland, who I'm pretty sure I have a non-aggression pact with. Well, what's this over here then? Hello. What are you guys? This is just... That's Bretonnia. And then this is... Oh, this is the sea. Who are you guys? You are the Skylings. You know what? We'll leave you alone for now. I don't think we need to worry about you lot just yet. But yeah, this is a big old territory. Let's see what it's got in it. Good quality production facilities, which is good. That means while we're in this area, we'll be able to recruit. So of course, this is technically a different province to Reichland. This is our first conquest outside of here. So it's already got some good facilities. It's got a brine mining pit, which produces salt and money. Good. That's presumably a good trade resource. Perfect. And that reminds me, by the way, we do indeed need to get some money back, so you cannot issue commandments. Oh, I don't want to issue a commandment over here. I want to issue a commandment over here. Now that this area is happy enough, Festag, I'm afraid, is kind of over. Instead, it's time for taxation. I'm sure you're just as excited by taxation as you were for Festag. So more money from tax and no more Festag. So alcohol is now cancelled. And taxation has replaced it. But taxation is just as good as alcohol, I'm sure you'll all agree. Now, the only downside we've got to all of this is, unfortunately, because this area was way over here, Marienburg didn't really have the opportunity to come and, you know, defend its little village or anything. And that means its army is still at strength in Marienburg. We need to go and take that out. In fact, I see no reason why we don't just move straight on. If we just leave now, what happens to the happiness of this settlement? The settlement goes, ooh, yes, conquest minus 10, but that's only for one turn. They don't like taxes. You know what? Just for once, let's be nice about this area. This area can be freed from taxation. I'm going to not bother taxing this area just yet. And that's going to be then provincial instability and then current. That will be fine. It will be totally, totally fine. It'll only go, conquest is only for one turn. We could build some troops to garrison. Ah, it's not worth it. It's totally not worth it. Let's just get our guys out of here. You, can you go into march mode? No, you cannot. Fine, having engaged in a fight, I think my guy's pretty much out of movement points. That's okay. Although we do have a leveling up to do. So he starts off with a fireball, which we can get the cooldown off. That's lovely. Let's get that done. Let's get our fireball a little bit better. Now, how does this guy's upgrade work? Because he's more of a get involved in the front line kind of a guy. Ooh. I can just get him a horse straight away. You know what? Screw it. Let's give him a horse. I'd say give the man a horse, totally. And then he can get a barded war horse next time. That's good. Just don't call him Daisy. I'm calling the war horse Daisy. Now you've said I can't. I'm totally doing that. Now, I do have to set that, or is it automatically set? No, he now has a warhorse automatically in his inventory. Beautiful. Now, a question I do have, actually. Are you allowed to do two things at once if they're in separate buildings and you can afford to do it? Yes, you can. That's interesting. So you're not limited to just one thing at once. Like, you're just limited to one thing per chain. So actually, you can be building, like, things in every single spot at the same time if you can just afford it. And meanwhile, the Talabeklan lads have now come to me. They want a defensive alliance and they'll toss in 600 gold. Done. Totally 100%. Now, yep, I've accepted their offer. Good. Now, things are going well over on the other side of the empire, but I feel like I should probably go and help out my friends with the vampire counts in a bit.
Enemy port. Obedience is becoming a problem here, my lord. Those that inhabit this place begin to stir against your rule. Appease or suppress them to snuff out dissent.
Don't worry, as soon as we've taken the rest of this area and thus we can issue commandments, I'm going to declare it Festag and it's beer for days. Then everyone will be happy and it will all be fine. Hello, a great migration comes to our borders demanding shelter from larger threats abroad. Do we let them cross into our territory or turn them away? Be gone, in which case nothing happens, or welcome, in which case migration. Public order, ooh, -3 for all provinces. No, sorry, be gone. Though the recruitment costs us, we're not really recruiting right now, and I don't need growth, so that's just a public order penalty. So, unfortunately, be gone. Be gone with ye. Right, next. Time to actually begin the proper full-scale war against Marienburg. But first, let's get a blacksmith in production over here. Yep, blacksmith in production. Very, very nice. John Dorf is now growing very, very quickly. Here we go. Straight in there. Troops right here. And can we get in there? On this occasion, sadly not, it appears I'm just shy of movement points. Oh well. These guys are offering peace and they're willing to toss in 1,000 gold. No. No, I think at this point we just want to own them. Go away. And Tabalakians, military access. Yeah, military access for the Tabalakians, done. Now, here we go. Following day, we're ready to actually begin a war here, but... here's the thing. We're a bit shy on money and could do with making some more, and I think this siege is going to last a few turns. So, the thing is, I could raid this place, but if I raid this place and then I take it over, that is -30 when raiding my own province. That's a bit of an issue, but it would get me a good, healthy amount. No, we're okay for money at the moment. We've got 1,000 surplus. Let's leave it as be and simply begin the war. Though, it looks like I could channel. Channeling, yeah. Minimum requirement to assume 50% total campaign. Campaign movement range -25%. I don't really need it. And then winds of magic power reserve +15. Could be useful for my battle wizard.
Very well.
Do it. And begin the war. So, what have we got there? Proper walls and available siege equipment. Siege tower x2 will cost 10 labor force. I have a massive labor force though, so I can produce these very, very quickly. And an imperial battering ram requires 6 labor force, and I've got loads of them. Perfect. Oh, labor force available per turn. Okay, so I've got a standing labor force of 119, and then if I start depleting that, it comes back at 8 a turn. Well, that's fine. I can start building some stuff here, but is that my only option? Fight a battle, auto-resolve a battle, break a siege, lift the siege, and retreat. Okay. And then, or just continue the siege. So continue the siege in order to construct further siege equipment, or attempt to wait out the enemy rather than assaulting. Turns remaining until supplies run out and the garrison starts suffering attrition. 8. Okay, I'd say we can just start building some siege equipment, and we'll see if they want to come out, because technically they are more powerful than us, so they may wish to sally. And it's going to take us 7 turns to build all the siege equipment I want anyway, so yes, this is going to take a little while. I'd say continue the siege. So while the siege is ongoing, let's just have a little quick look what's going on over here and remind myself what deal I've got with both of these lads. Yeah, I've got military access to these lads over here, the Sterling lot, and they are going to be at war against the undead. Yeah, we might go and join in with that later, but for now we need to focus on upgrading our technology and making sure we just win this war against the Marienburg lot. But first, another mission. Lair of the Orc Lord. Hunt down the Orc Lord that is ravaging our lands. There's an Orc Lord that's ravaging our lands, are you sure? Alright, fine, whatever. Kill the mongrel, one less threat to the throne. Argnok Cracktooth. Five turns to complete, and I will get a Ruby Ring of Ruin. Okay, could be useful for one of my magicians there. Where is he, by the way? We don't even own that land. Why are we concerned about that land? As far as I can see, this Bright Wizard is just, like, embedded in this army permanently. I don't see a way to get him out of it. I don't want to disband him or rename him. And there's no options, like, over here. I can just, like, examine him and his rank and so forth. But as far as I can tell, there's no way to, like, unattach him from the army he's attached to. So I'd need to train a new assassin, but as far as I'm aware, I don't have the ability to train any new assassins. So unfortunately, we may just have to leave that one down. Wizenland versus Averland. Wait, hang on. Wizenland and Averland, you guys are supposed to be fine. If the Imperial heirs want to go to war with each other, that's all A-okay, I don't mind. Marienburg is starting to get a little bit more on the desperate side right now. They've offered more and more money for peace. What else can we potentially force out of them? If they're willing to totally join a confederacy with us, join a confederacy, apparently they're totally not going to be up for that. Nah, we just don't accept. And Tempelhof is apparently dead. That's nice. The forces of Talabakland instead took that area for them, and now they are right on the cusp of, well, taking out the main area of the vampire camp. So I suspect Castle Tempelhof is going to be a little bit difficult to take over. So a new mission, go and raid a land way over here. Though admittedly not too far away. We'll get some reputation with Middenland, also some money, which would be useful. Who even are these guys? Well, they seem to be friends of Talabekland. No, screw Middenland, I don't care. Ah, and we have a ton of new technologies come available as well at the moment. So, state troop musicals, yes, plus 5% Empire infantry speed movement, fine. The barracks. Now, this is interesting. Drafting the irregulars, so minus 5% for Empire infantry units at upkeep. Okay, that's good. Supply wagons, global recruitment capacity plus 1. Ah, recruiting extra troops, that's good. Or volley fire and reload time reduction, minus 15%. Ooh, that is tempting. That is, let's go for the money though. We need money. That's a good thing to be working on. Oh, can we literally only be working on one of these at once? Oh, okay, it is literally just one. In which case, I'll still go for this because yes, I'd say minus 5% for all Imperial upkeep. That's very, very useful. And something very significant has just happened. Storm clouds are gathering in the north. There are rumors the barbarous tribes residing in the shadow of chaos have ceased striving against each other for the attention of the dark gods and are instead banding together, suckling at the teat of chaos. I like that expression. Only a matter of time before the dam breaks and a tide of ruin engulfs the old world. Dear, oh dear. Right, okay, so we've got a bit of a barbarian invasion event occurring soonish. Got it. And for 3 turns, apparently, we've got a recruitment shortage for the minute because of, because I've been going to war for a little while, therefore we're struggling to recruit more troops. That's fine, I'm not going to be recruiting for a little bit anyway. I'm currently focusing on technology and the siege. Now, we do have a small problem over here in the west, which is Essen, which I think used to belong to, well, one of the Empire's kind of friends, sort of fallen to Manfred von Karstein, who appears to be a bit of a bad person. So that's a bit of an issue. We should probably be a little bit careful of this whole situation right here. If they decide to come against the forces of humanity any further, we potentially may wish to... Ooh, hello. You've got a wonderful little cute thing here. We may wish to send an army to assist. The vampire counts, meanwhile, actually are looking for peace. I'm not sure I want peace with them, to be honest. No, no, go away. Even though you're offering 600 gold is really not very much. Go away, you. This will be your undoing. Maybe, maybe not. So it's a few turns later and I think we're ready to actually start recruiting that glorious army I started mentioning. So right now, you know, Balthazar Gelt's just chilling out here with some swordsmen and some spearmen, but a lot of new stuff just became available. In particular, we now have, oh yes... We have the Empire Knights. Excellent. They don't even actually cost that much to maintain. Oh, but they cost a lot to recruit. Oh, blimey. Oh, yeah, the upkeep's not so bad, but that upfront cost. Maybe we'll just kind of get, like, a few of you. You're anti-infantry, but presumably not spearmen. You don't actually mean a spearman there. I'm going to guess you get, yeah, high speed, good armor, good leadership. Charge bonus. Yeah, big charge bonus, all things considered. Yeah, normal charge bonus for, like, these lads is, like, you know, 5, 16, something. These guys are pretty damn powerful already, but, yeah, get a massive charge bonus. So we should just deploy them like we normally would do in cavalry anyway. Okay, so time to start building an army that we're going to be sending against the vampire counts. Things that we need. 1, halberds. They are effective against large, so if giants are coming in, we can deal with giants. Actually, no, before we get started, you have no experience. Go away, get out of the army. So we're going to be sending some more swordsmen into the army, of course. Yep, swordsmen. And we're also going to be bringing in, actually, you know what? Do we want to get rid of the basic spearmen as well? No, the basic spearmen probably still have a point. They can just be, like, you know, supporters. I mean, the difference between these guys is not so great. Let's bring in some of the halberds as well. That's good. And then that's going to be enough for the moment. Let's start bringing in some crossbowmen as well. We're building a big army here. This is going to start eating into the amount of money we're raising very, very quickly, in fact. How's the war going, by the way? So at this point, they have actually run out of supplies. Beautiful. So they're going to start taking some attrition. Let's wear them down a little bit, but I would actually like to take part in a siege against them if I have the opportunity to. Now, Wizenland, who have always been friendly to me, want me to go to war against the bastards of Averland. I see no reason why not. They wanted to pay 300 gold for that. Sure, I've got a small army in production right now. Balthazar can go and take care of that while we're wrapping up the Marienburg lot. Now, we've got a small problem here, which is we've basically entirely run out of money. But that's fine. That's totally 100% fine, because we are going to be going to war now, and we're going to be doing a lot of damage to some folks. So, 13 stack army, I'd say you go into march mode and head on our way. We're allowed to go straight into this area. We've kind of got friendly relationships with these guys, don't we? Yeah. We're allies towards them. I'm pretty sure the blue border means I'm allowed to just cut through. The guys you want me to go to war with are these gits down here, and I need to join up with my friends of Wissenberg, who are you, to do that. That's fine. In that case, let's just send our troops over in this direction. You didn't want me here, though. Just move our troops over this way. Oh, you can move so far. It's pleasing. So you guys head over here. Actually, stop right there. Stop right there, because then we can actually acquire more people this turn, which will be good. Oh, no, sorry, you can't, because you're marching anyway. That's fine. This army's big enough. Now, you don't mind me coming in here, do you? You're fine with me because we're allies. Yeah, all right, fine. Everything's fine. The vampire counts are increasingly desperate for peace, which is fine because I'm increasingly desperate for money. Meanwhile, there's apparently trouble in Aleheart. Ghettos, areas left abandoned, a mysterious triangle on a nearby wall or gate. I have no idea what that means. All right, fine. Apparently there's going to be negative growth in Aleheart. That's a shame. That means there's going to be... Actually, no, we've got plenty of spare capacity at the moment. We've got plenty of surplus population, so it's not an issue. Ah, the enemy's being worn down fast now. Now that we've worn them down, they are... Oh, my goodness, yes. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You know what? I think we're going in. I'd say I didn't realize when it said you're being worn down, it was that damn fast. It didn't used to be that damn fast, but I like this. Once you've worn down their supplies, they really do start starving quickly. All right, fine. I think it's time for war. With our 2 battering rams, 10 siege towers, and indeed not much left in the kitty for any of you lot, let's go. So it looks like on this occasion we don't get a choice. We've got to approach from one angle. You've kind of got to go from the front into their gates. You can't go around the back of them. I guess that means, actually, you know what, they've got their back to the sea, haven't they? Which kind of makes sense, therefore. And indeed, there we go. So, like, they've got the big walls here. Shorter walls that we actually might be able to take here. Then we've got, what else have we got? Then, yeah, bigger walls around here. So, really, if they just hadn't built such small walls here, we'd have no way of, we'd have literally no way of taking them. So, that was a bit of a bad decision on their part. And the back of them is presumably to the sea or to the mountains or whatever, so that's fine. Let's go and have a look-see, actually, because we are allowed to, like, have a poke around here. Yeah, nice city. Like this city. Looking forward to owning it. Now, the question is, how dangerous are the towers going to be? Because that really depends game to game. Makes a big difference game to game how powerful the towers are going to be. And we need to control this plaza same as it ever was. So all we need to do is, yes, destroy this area. And potentially, our mortars can hopefully help out with this a lot. Where are our mortars? Our mortars can be, like, over here. That's fine. So our mortars are well within range of the towers there. And now let's just spread out our lads too. Oh, this is cute, and they've kind of improvised a bit of a cover for the battering ram by tying shields to it, so it's a little bit less flammable. That's lovely. Well, that's spread out enough. Start the deployment and start the battle. We have got 1 hour to take them out. That should hopefully be plenty of time. Okay, so we've learned something straight away, which is these guys are in range immediately. Question then is, oh yeah, there's not much here. You know what? Let's just start our guys moving forward. You lot, take this wall. You lot, this wall here. Towers are moving into position. Now to figure out what my mortars can or can't do to help. Can my mortars take out this here thing? So wall, tower, looks like it. It does look like that's a thing that I can attack. So yes, my mortars can go for these lads. So if I just basically start blasting these walls, actually, you know what I do think? Why bother sending my troops in to take damage when there's... Ah, you know what, screw it, just move in. We'll be able to fix them up later. Let's just see how effective our guys are at taking out the walls. Begin the attacks. My mortars are going for those walls. And my lads are... Here we go. In come the attacks. And how much damage does this do? Not much if it misses. And here comes the whistling of more. And like 2%. Okay. So a basic mortar can do very, very small amounts of damage against a tower. Fine. We shouldn't even really kind of bother doing that, to be honest. Looks like they're abandoning the walls straight away, which is fine. Where's my wizard? My wizard is at the back here. My wizard has a fireball spell. Can he use it on the walls? Looks like he can. Excellent. But obviously, we've got to actually have them holding still before that happens. If we have a group that decides they want to hold still, that's okay. All right, they're abandoning the walls. And if they abandon the walls, that means the towers stop firing. That works for me. Looks to me like they are... Are you guys taking damage? Would you mind just... If you're taking damage, just step back, please. Don't get yourself involved. So, my lads get up here. My lord is under attack. Whoa, what's going on here? Are you all ridiculously too close or something? Guys, everyone get back a bit. Apparently we're just a little bit too close to the... No, not you. You stay over wherever it is you're going. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, it looks like the range on the towers is actually pretty damn long, so you've got to be a bit careful of that. Now, we just need these guys to just kind of come in here. It looks like we've got our lads up on the walls already. In fact, right, slow time to half here. So now that we've got these lads on the walls, did they become friendly towers? Yes, the friendly towers thing is back. Beautiful. Guys, go and attack their sword infantry. We're going to have more guys this side. Go and attack them. And now our wizard can come over here in a second. And just start. Here we go. This I want to see. One fireball coming in. And where's the fireball? Here's the fireball. Oh, he actually casts it and it comes. It doesn't come out the sky. He actually casts it. And it does literally nothing because they're defended by the walls. Beautiful. You lot, go and support. Meanwhile, we're going to be heading over here. So yeah, it's a traditional kind of total war thing, which is when you get up onto the wall, it's a real scrap. One thing our mortars may well be able to do, though, is just drop in some attacks on their crappy little lads that are next. So let's get our mortars turned around and start dropping some fire on these crossbowmen. Lovely. Because if we can just wrest control of these towers off these lads, that will all be fine. You're just over... I don't know why you're even here. Go back over there. Just back out the way of their towers for a second. Ah, here we are. We are indeed dropping the mortars on top of them. Keep it on them. Keep it on them. Our swordsmen should be able to win this fight fairly easily. They have a massive numerical advantage. They're actually significantly stronger as well because they've got experience and whatnot. Where are my great swordsmen? Ah, my great swordsmen are in here as well. They'll cut through the swordsmen like butter. That's fine. We've got extra reinforcements back here I haven't really dealt with yet. And the game politely kind of lays out how it works now, which is if you hold this area, you hold this tower. And now we hold this tower. And if we control the balance of power, have we got some more troops? Yeah, we've got more backup troops over here. If we can just seize control of this tower. And the gates have been forced open. Nice, open gates. You are now a traditional unit. Get in there, take out... Oh, they've got a mortar. Get in there and take out their mortar, please. Oh, I think the flipping battering ram just ceased to exist. Marvelous. So you are now going to get out of here. Marvellous. And our mortar can just keep firing on these lads. Not going to do much good to them, to be honest. Gatehouse is damaged. They have pistol cavalry. And anything else? Yeah, they've got a few, like, damaged units over here. They've got, their leader. If we take out their leader, actually, that works out quite well. So let's take out the siege thing. And if our swordsmen here can just take out their leader, then the guys on the walls will absolutely break. We've got more guys here. You, go and take care of... Actually, just go around the outside here. Oh, what are you doing? Spearmen. Why are you getting... Okay, fine. You get involved with them. Swordsmen will easily take out spearmen. Sadly, it means their pistol guys are now going to get some easy shots at my lads, which is a shame. Right, I'm sending in my own pistol cavalry to just go and support. They're just going to go and shoot their pistol cavalry. My lads are easily... My swordsmen will easily take out these spearmen, but I'm guessing the usual rules apply, which is, yes, once you're on the town plaza, then you cannot rout at that point. It doesn't matter. On the plus side, yeah, we got our cavalry coming in at this point. I think we now control everything. Yeah, get in there. Our lads can now stop firing, so they'll probably do more friendly damage than anything else. Get in there. Nice. These lads are really starting to struggle. Alright, they're almost all dead at this point. I believe this is the last unit of that. Oh, they had halberd infantry and everything. This might be part of the garrison. What's going on down here? If their leader falls, we're doing well. Where's our cavalry? Cavalry, I told you to get in it. Cavalry, get in here. Go on, through here, please. In you go. Skirmish mode off, please. Over here. And take out these lads. Thank you. Right, their cavalry has just decided to run off for whatever reason. I think we've won. We have won because we have seized the, where are they running to? Oh, are they allowed to retreat? They've retreated deeper into the city. We don't even need to take the whole city. We just need to take the area at the front. And we've officially won. All right, okay, so that's changed. Now, as long as you take, the plaza at the front of the city, that's it, you have officially won. That is nice, because it means they are actually allowed to retreat, because they can retreat back to this area. The plaza falls unquestionably into our hands. End the battle. Marvellous. Now, I've got bad news, guys, which is we've got a bit of a deficit going on, and you guys have a lot of stuff we could potentially be stealing. So, you know, there's reasons we might want to be taking over your city. Lots of reasons. You're going to get a load of experience. A sword of battle. Nice. What to do with these bastards? Ooh, hello. Subjugate. You'll become the master of the conquered faction and they will become your vassal, paying tribute each turn. All captives are enslaved. Ah, okay. That's intriguing. Or we've got the usual business. We could earn 7,000 right now. But some provincial instability, which is a problem if we were to sack this city. But we'd have a huge influx of money, or we could just occupy and make basically no bloody money whatsoever, but we wouldn't have the issues. Ooh, do I want to subjugate them? Well, they will obey my rule and supply me with additional income. That's not a bad deal. You know what? Just for fun, as this is the new thing, you are going to be subjugated. Congratulations, you are now subjugated. He's got himself a sword of battle. Nice. An income from trade plus 5% trade agreement tariffs faction-wide. A fisherman. A fisherman just got the entire trade of the entire empire up by 5%. That is impressive right there. So you are now my vassals. Perfect. And because I've done that, I can't actually control their, building or anything. But am I allowed to tax them? I am allowed to tax them here in the Wasteland. Interesting. Apparently this is the Wasteland. Oh no, sorry. That's the tax just for these guys in that case, isn't it? Yes, I see. But because I own the whole area, Festag time. So it's Festag time, which means we can start taxing Gorsal, which will get us a fair bit more money. And we can move our armies out of this region and return them to friendly territory. Perfectamundo. And as we enter our own territory, you can see just there that one of those guys started healing a bit more, because presumably, you know, we've got more of our own troops we can acquire here. So, Marienburg now our vassal. Perfect. Now, I hope they can't rebel, because if they do rebel, I'm just going to go and bloody destroy them next time. I will not bother being polite. But yes, subjugated. Perfect. So with that little war complete, ladies and gentlemen, and the forces of Marienburg, now my vassals paying me money every single turn, we're back into a surplus. We've got a healthy little kind of treasury back here. And more importantly, we've got more and more friends over to the south and the west of us. We can go and help out against these bastards, whoever they are exactly, because we do indeed have Balthazar Gelt heading down into this part of the world. He doesn't have the largest army, to be honest, but I'm sure he'll be fine. They're good quality troops. But as the vampire count seem to be causing a bit of trouble, I think it would be remiss of us not to go and help our friends out. So, coming soon, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to go and send our main army against the vampire counts and fight the forces of the undead. But in the meantime, ladies and gentlemen, I've been John. This has been many a true nerd. This has been the really rather excellent Total War Warhammer. Thank you very much, and goodbye.
Down, 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 get off it. Just hop off. Oh, no, that was wrong!
I would untie and save you, you understand, but there is a hovercraft.
I really hope the bear's not still around. The bear is still around! The bear's still around! The bear's still around! Good news, guys! Elephant's here! Hey!